one, it is the 25th of November. This is going to be a blend of, well, it's all a channeled message, but I'm being driven to do a continuation of my last video of Are You Ignoring the Signs? In the sense that I have to further explain the thorn in my side, which was addressing my father with the messages that I was spiritually picking up on. So these external messages, like signs that I was getting for me to communicate with my father about what I was seeing, started bubbling up in ways that I wasn't comfortable with. And it really shone a mirror to me that I was essentially very subtly letting evil seep into my life. And how that is because I kept falling further and further into ego of saying, well, if my dad is spiritually in tune, if he's spiritually enriched and all his family is, and I already knew this and now it's being confirmed in all these other ways, then he can deal with it. That's not my circus to deal with. I don't want to be a part of it. I already set a boundary and I'm not gonna communicate with them. That's their problem. And that's me masking my own thorn, my own pain, by saying I'm going to just stick to what I say beyond what it is that I truly believe. Because beyond that, I had already made a promise to myself that I would do my best to constantly be self-aware and pretty much find ways that I need, like, the necessity of dissolving the ego. Obviously, we need boundaries. We need ways for us to have exist in this world, in a world where not everyone is of love and light. And, you know, obviously, we have our own transgressions, just like this example here. But I'm committed to my spiritual path of, irregardless of my egotistical blocks, I guess, I need to do what's right. Ultimately, I need to move with integrity. I need to move with honesty. I need to move with what spirit tells me, like what God tells me to do. And so this was such a minor obstacle. This was such a minor test that thankfully I have proceeded forward and deliver the message. But, you know, it's kind of like, well, if I don't deal with this thorn, then what about the bigger obstacles? What about the bigger challenges? What about the bigger situations where evil is, like I've said before, it permeates people in places where you are unhealed. So you have to constantly be aware, be self-aware, and be honest about wanting to heal. It wasn't that, you know, like I said, like I talk to my dad from time to time. I talk to him. Like I keep that communication open. But it was like, it was coming from a place of just like being guarded and like cynical and bitter of being like, it reminded me of my childhood, basically, of like, exactly, like this is my point, that he's aware. He's not just aware in a logical sense and an intuitive sense, but it's like even on a deeper layer of it, of being psychic and like having a lineage of psychics, and yet you allowed a vulnerable person, me, like a child, into situations that I should have never been in when you knew better. So who am I to come save you? Or who am I to deliver you something? You know, like, who am I to help you? Well, who am I is, that's, it doesn't, like, spirit, the light, does not hold grudges. Does not limit itself to the ego. It doesn't limit itself to that. It just does what's right. It just is and does what's right. So I have to follow that, right? And so the continuation of that is because I feel that there's healing that's occurring within you. I feel like there's healing of like understanding the thorn or thorns inside of you and how it, you know, you get the thorn inside of you or splinter, right? And for a while you can ignore it. They're showing me like the spine, the spinal cord, and like all the little neurotransmitters like going to a thorn. And as it comes to the surface to break out of the body to release itself, because it's not supposed to be there, all your attention of your entire being, this huge body and a teeny tiny thorn, but all of that pressure and that pain is and focus is on this thorn. And so paying attention to where all of that, like, it's, you know, when I was going through this, I was not doing readings, I was not, like, at all, like, not online, not in person, for myself. I was just, like, in a cloud. I was in a cloud. It was like a backlog of just everything going on in my life. And so it gets really, like, the disturbance gets awoken, right? It's kind of like they're also showing me how, like, it, you know, in the water, like in the sand, and if you kick up the sand and how it causes cloudiness in the sand and then it eventually dissipates. So it's like all your attention is going to this thorn, and you have a choice of what you want to do with it. Do you want to, like, push it back down because it's too painful and then it toxifies your entire body? Is that what you want to do? Or do you want to deal with it and let what the natural progression of things is, which is your body's going to naturally want to dispel it. So do you want to do that? Do you want to help dispel this thorn? Or do you want to make it stay there longer than it needs to be, and or worse, have it poison your system? And so I see you making the decision to move towards healing. I see you moving towards it because it's the natural order of things, and you not resisting healing. I see you detoxifying yourself of something that didn't belong inside of your awareness, inside of your being, inside of your thought, and it's like this didn't belong to you to begin with, and so you carried it around for so long, and now it's time to let it go. Now it's time to heal, to release it. And I'm seeing a significance to the springtime. March, April, May. And so no matter what time you're watching this video, if you're watching it in spring, then it would happen during that season. If you're watching in the summertime, then it's a full circle around to the next spring. If you're watching it when I release it, this upcoming spring, there is it's like a it's not a misdirection. It's like, okay, what I'm seeing is like you're working on something currently, or you're going to be, no, it's something that you're already planning, and you're just continuing to do. So like, let's say, for instance, let's say you're trying to lose weight, okay, and you're saying, you know, I want to work on my health so that I can have like a long, active life. And so you're working out, and in the background of your mind there's like a lot of pressure that you're putting on yourself without really fully realizing that it's still there. It's like you're restructuring your mindset of saying I'm focusing and gearing it towards health. It's not towards appearance. It's about longevity. It's not about, you know, social acceptance or whatever. And so you're doing these things, but in the back of your mind, there's something still lingering you know, and you don't realize that you've already made the change. You know, it's almost like a disassociation where it's like you're still doing things that are going towards the negative side. It's like, do you get what I'm saying? It's like there's something that's like you're not really aware that you're doing. And then what happens is, and you're more healed than you realize, essentially. Like you're more advanced than you realize. And so come springtime, something is going to misdirect your attention. And when you refocus, then you're going to realize just how much progress you made. It's like, have you ever walked past a mirror and you don't realize it's you? It's kind of that same energy where, let's say, if we want to keep with this example, then it's like, you know that you're healthy, you know that you're more active, you know that you feel comfortable, you know that you're buying new clothes and it fits the way that you want it to fit, and you know you're getting good sleep and all of this stuff, like everything's just where it feels it should be. But again, it's this strange energy that's kind of still there. So as you're shopping, you don't see yourself, you don't recognize yourself in the mirror because you're too busy thinking about something else, and you're like, that person looks so good. And then you look back and you're like, oh my gosh, that's me. And it kind of like sinks in where it's like, I've been looking at myself, I've been perceiving myself in one way, and I didn't realize how hard I was still being on myself. It was, I can equate this to passion. I can equate this to passion or like a starving artist and all this stuff. It's like, there's different layers to passion. There's different layers to artistic expression. There's different layers to all of this, in the sense that sometimes passion can be driven by desperation. Sometimes passion can be driven from the lack of, right? Or like, again, the starving artist, it's like the lack of something that drives the creativity to get to something that you want. And so it's like you're driven to do something because you feel you are without, only to come to the realization that you're moving seamlessly, you're enjoying it. Because if you look at someone who is just purely passionate because it's like their calling or they're good at it or whatever, it's more of like this playful essence to them, or a childlike essence to them, or just like there's no like real focus or significance or like it's just second nature. It just is. It's just part of their life. It's just what they do. You know, it's like that kind of thing. Or an artist who's made it, but then that's their passion, in the sense that that's their calling, or like that's just part of who they are. It's like they have the freedom of expression and exploration and things that they perceive and do and project onto their artwork, that is just, you know, it's pulling from the ethers, right? Passion and creativity, like all of that. It's like, you get what I'm saying? So it's that realization of, I'm no longer without. I am with, and I'm enjoying it. And that's what's happening in the spring. That's number one. Message, well, technically message number two, because what I was talking about with the thorn and me and all that, that has something to do with you as well, in whatever way that, I'm not sure. The other message I'm getting is 20? Okay, because I was going to say 12 to 30. Maybe 20 is the sweet spot, but it's 12 to 30 months. So that's 1 to 2.5 years, but the sweet spot is possibly 20 months from now. So from... okay, I'm getting multiple messages. I'm seeing myself projecting into the future, and someone watching this like 30 months from the time that I posted, and then realizing how relevant it is to their story. So it's like 30 months from now, you look at this video and you're like, this is what happened to me. She picked up on something that I had experienced. And it's like this like warm, fuzzy feeling where it's like, I did this. Like, I really did that. And so what I'm saying is, this is varying. It's either like right now, like the date, and I don't care how long later you see this, it's like from the date that I post this. I'm pretty sure, like, it doesn't feel like it's changing. I'm like trying to move myself in different dates, and it seems like from November 25th, 2022, 12 months to 30 months, potentially 20 months, from today, it's like magic. Like, it feels like something that you've been working towards, working on, desiring, wanting. The word that I'm really getting is manifesting, and I want to be clear on the manifestation that I'm talking about, which is a manifestation is the ability. It varies again, it varies on how the context, but this context is your ability to perceive and project yourself into the future and to perceive either your destined path or potentials of your destiny that you can go down, like fated courses of action that you see are available to you, that you desire, and you are making concrete, tangible, logical steps to go towards. And in those months, a year to 2.5 years from now, you are either like, it's like hit the ground running doing it, or it's like you're at the very beginning stages and you know it, like it's like there. It's like, let's say you see yourself in some apartment in the New York City skyline view, and 2.5 years from now, max, you are now finally moving. You sold the stuff you need to sell. You got the job you needed in, you know, in the city or Connecticut or I don't know where, but that's where you wanted to live. And so it's like, you're there. Or you're literally like, you have everything. Now you just have to do the final workings to get that. Okay. I'm just gonna name off some things for you that I was seeing that led me to this. I saw a flock of white doves. Like, I literally saw them outside. This isn't like in my mind. I literally saw a flock of white doves, and it brought me to attention of wonderment and healing and beauty and traditional signs, which is going to be a repeat theme here. Then I saw a fancy goldfish. And I see like endowment when it comes to you. So it's like the riches, but it's in a fulfilling way. So whether you are desiring money or whatever for a sense of security, then it's like that, or it's like the riches in the sense of it's an inner fulfillment, but it's somehow tied to your physical environment that is going to bring you some sort of inner peace. And again, this, like, I can feel it, like, here, like, my ears, all the way to my heart. It's just warm. It's, like, warm, tingly, soft, loving, comforting, relaxing, at peace. And it's, like, now I can be me. Now all of this drama, this stress, this stuff that I was yearning for or needing to be at peace, it's like, because sometimes, like, literally physically we need certain things to work out. You can be as calm inside as possible, but the physical reality of things obviously takes a toll, and that's coming to an end, whatever these issues are. It just feels like blessings and blessings and blessings. That's literally what I see, is like you being like, whoa, I am so blessed. I'm so, I can't believe it. You know, it feels like I have the Midas touch. And then I saw the fancy goldfish. I actually, it's back there. And it kept drawing my attention, drawing my attention, drawing my attention. It's, I don't think they're koi fish, unless koi fish are goldfish. Maybe they're a fancy goldfish, but that looks like a super fancy goldfish. It doesn't look like a koi. Anyway, and then I saw, this is how I knew, the first sign I got, I knew it was a collective reading. Because I kept hearing collective, and I was hearing this dialogue of what I told you guys, or just like the frameworks of it, and I kept hearing collective, collective, collective. And then I got up and I looked outside my door, and it's the season of the swallow birds' migration. So they blanket the sky here as they migrate south, and they're so beautiful. They create like ribbons in the sky, and they swallow up all the insects, you know, they clean the crops of things that don't need to be there. And I see them as the collective, like working towards healing. Like each of us are individually working towards healing in our own unique ways. And then these blessings, these messages of blessings, is some collective message, but is unique to each individual. And I'm seeing, and then I saw an owl, and it flew on a tree. It wasn't looking at the swallows, it was doing its own thing. It perched up on a tree, and then it flew down, and I saw the owl, and I think that's the deepening of your wisdom. And it's like this feeling of like, again, with the collective, but it's like, I don't really care what other people are doing, or I don't care what other people are saying, or I don't really care about that. I'm focused on, my inner development, and like how enlightened I can become. And by becoming more enlightened, it's by focusing on the things that bring me fulfillment or joy. And then it just kind of like, it's like prosperous. I just see like raining down blessings, you know. And these key points that I talked about in the springtime, and these key points of 30 months maximum from now, you know, those are just main hallmarks of things, but I'm just seeing in between, it's like just raining down blessings, raining down, raining down, raining down. And then the last sign that I saw, that I know has to do with this, is a bluebird. There's a bluebird that keeps showing up on the railing. It's so cute, and it's not scared of my cat, because sometimes I'll have the door open and my cat's, you know, being a kitty cat and making noises, and sometimes the birds will take notice and kind of scooch away. Like, they'll still stay nearby, but they'll kind of go away just in case. And this bluebird, I call it Antoinella's bluebird. Antoinella's my cat, because they don't care. Antoinella made like a couple noises, but like, they're fine. And so it was this sense of like, again, wonderment. And so I would look up, if you want to look up the different meanings of each animal that I spoke of, but ultimately what I'm seeing here is tradition, traditional signs, paying attention to traditional signs. In the sense of what that, I don't know what it means for you or your culture, or even just whatever you've created in your mind, where it's like, if I find a coin, then that means something. If I see a feather, that means something. It's like, pay attention to signs that are so blatantly traditional like what everyone around you, everyone in your culture, any time that you would ever consider it to be a straightforward sign, you're gonna keep getting these towards you. And it brings me back to, it's gonna be very loud. It's gonna be very loud, because when I was talking about, are you ignoring the signs, and I saw the fat fox squirrel and I saw the deer, it's like, could not ignore it. And so that's what I'm seeing here, is like, these signs you will not be able to ignore, because it's so clear. It's so clear to you. And the word traditional, it's so traditional to you. So that's what I see for you guys. I kind of want to say congratulations. So congratulations on your blessings and your hard work, and your endowment. That's it. Bye.